Hi everyone, I'm Francesco Calivá from the CI Square at UCSF. I'm pleased to present our work. I have nothing to disclose. These are the funding sources. We devised a deep learning framework for simultaneous MRI reconstruction and segmentation from highly undersampled MRIs. Our method exploits the power of deep multitask learning to achieve reconstruction in the image domain learning space. This is the architecture that we propose. We name it TB-recon. The network consumes zero-field undersampled MRIs. It presents a shared feature encoder along which there are residual blocks. At its bottom, there is a common feature embedding. The architecture has two decoders, both inverted replicas of the encoder. One performs image reconstruction, the other segmentation. The reconstruction one receives features from the encoder through skip connections. These support image denoising and facilitate reconstruction at high acceleration factors. The segmentation decoder presents what we call inter-task skip connections, which facilitate the flow of features among tasks. This is a novel contribution of our architecture. We experimentally observed that the use of inter-task connections results in better segmentation performance. This is because the features available along the reconstruction leg of the network are representative of finer details, which are formulated during the MRI reconstruction. The network is trained end-to-end. To do so, it minimizes a multitask loss with a reconstruction and a segmentation term. Alpha, beta, and gamma are hyperparameters empirically set to rescale the losses and balance the importance of each task. During training, die score is monitored. This makes the reconstruction an auxiliary task, as we primarily focus on the image segmentation. Dropout and early stopping were employed to regularize training. To test our method, we use a subset of the OI dataset, comprising 174 knee-based MRIs, for which we had available manual annotation of the cartilage compartment and the menisci. OI dataset doesn't comprise raw data. We perform undersampling by applying the fast Fourier transform to revert the image to k-space. Then we applied a Poisson undersampling disk at a given acceleration factor. We zero field and inverse Fourier transform the signal to the image space to complete the undersampling. This is an example of segmentation performance of the TB-recon at different acceleration factors. A point-by-point surface distance between the automatic and the manual segmentation is shown. As we can see, the errors lie within the pixel spacing range. This is an example of image reconstruction. The arrow points to a full thickness cartilage loss in lateral femoral cartilage. The same lesion is well observed also in the MRI reconstructed at high acceleration factor. We conducted an ablation study to demonstrate the importance of performing image reconstruction at intermediate tasks to the segmentation and prove the beneficial effect of inter-task skip connections. From the results, it can be observed that segmentation directly from undersampled data is unfeasible, especially at high acceleration factors. We also demonstrated the added value of the proposed inter-task skip connections. In this table, naive refers to the same architecture of the TB-recon, where the inter-task skip connections were substituted by traditional encoder-decoder connections. From the results, we conclude that the novelty of having skip connections between the decoders is beneficial, leading to significantly improved segmentation. For more details, please refer to our paper. To conclude, we proposed TB-recon, a solution for simultaneous MRI reconstruction and segmentation, which enables ultra-fast task-based MRI reconstruction. We argue this is facilitated by the shared encoder and the inter-task skip connections between the decoders which we introduce. In a broader scale, we argue that task-based reconstruction can push the boundaries of fast images far beyond the acceleration factor that have been utilized in the past. We suggest that MRI practice can benefit from task-based reconstruction with potential application for a plethora of well-defined tasks. Overall, we hope this paper further stimulates the research community's interest on task-based fast MRI. I would like to thank my research team and the funding sources. Thanks for watching.